location.
Yeah.
Different things.
Yeah.
Oh, well, Steve is doing the ceremony.
Okay.
Yeah. So we're really excited. We did the premarital counseling.
Awesome.
With Sejahdah and Anthony.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's good.
They're really fun.
That's good.
Really, really fun couple.
Yeah.
We're not done. We still have a couple sessions, but we're going to do afterwards.
That's good. I know Christy and Vera as well.
Yeah, yeah.
Christy and I used to attend together.
Okay, yeah. Okay, yeah. Yep. We do a lot of that. We do a lot of premarital counseling.
That's good.
It's fun. We love it.
Yeah.
We love doing it.
That's good.
Yeah. It's really fun. I like to give them a hard time. I mean, somebody has to. It's like, well, these guys, how can we all go to some flowers?
And then on
your wife. I don't know. Because you've got such a great smile.
Thank you. so glad that you responded to the invitation to be part of this couple's wedding and to see what God is doing in this moment. And I want to encourage you, you may have some tears. I hope they're tears of joy, and I hope you have some laughter as well. To enjoy this moment, to see that God is doing something incredible, and we get to be a part of it. So you join me in prayer real quick, and let's just invite his presence. And thank you for being here. Father God, thank you for Anthony, for Sejahdah, for their parents, for their family. We ask, Lord, that in this moment, your presence would be made known and prevail over this ceremony. But it would be more than just a ceremony. We would experience the miracle of you putting two people together and making them one. And we experience the joy of your presence so that we can acknowledge that you're doing something wonderful here. So bless each one, encourage each one, and especially for Anthony and Sejahdah. May this be the day they remember all the rest of their lives as the moment you did something very unique and special. Putting them together and making them one. And we thank you for that in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. So, first I want to ask the parents, Mr. and Mrs. Brimmer, are you willing to take Sejahdah as your daughter? She's going to be your daughter-in-law. And are you willing to release your son to be your husband?
Yes, we are.
Praise the Lord. And now, Dad, who is it that gives us thank you for standing. You may be seated. Praise the Lord. Well, I'm going to give these two just a moment to relax. And I'm going to share just a brief moment about marriage. Anybody in this room married? A few of you. If you've been married more than 5 days, you know that marriage is difficult. Anybody agree with that?
Yeah.
Remember, we don't have to be silent here. I mean, this is not a moral service. This is a wedding. We enjoy his time. You know, in Genesis, it says that God created the man, breathed into him, he became a living soul, placed him in a garden. It was of a profession. Walk with him, talk with him. And this man was able to produce things based on the fact that he just began to understand how to cultivate the earth that God created. And it produced for him. It was abundant. So what did this man need? In the midst of all this beauty and without anyone else there to bother him and just walking with God in the midst of profession, God looked upon him and said, "You're not quite finished. You're not done yet. I'm going to make someone to come alongside you to help you with your life's work, to be a mirror image to you, to be a partner to you, to be a teammate with you, to walk through life." And so God asked Adam about naming the animals. He did that because I think Adam, like most of us men, don't realize what's going on. Like we're a little behind the times, behind the scenes. We get things a little later than you women do. So he went out and named all the animals. He went out and named all the animals and realized he's the only one of his kind. And in that moment, God caused a deep sleep to fall upon him. But Adam had to be willing to give his life away. And that's the first step of having a successful marriage. It's when the husband realizes when he gives his life away to his bride, she responds by giving her life away, and then they become one. Adam died in that moment. God took from his side all that was necessary to form another living human being. And in so doing, created the woman. And then awoke Adam from the sleep. And the first thing Adam said when he saw his bride was, "Wow." Well, that's a rough translation of Hebrew. He definitely saw the beauty that God had made and stood before him. And he declared, "This is one of my bones, flesh of my flesh. This is equal to me. This is another living human being, just like me. But there is a difference." And this is the other thing that is unique about marriage. It's male and female. So this will be called womb man. This was taken from man. And this tells us a lot about God's intention. He created us equal. male and female. He created us to be together, to be united, to be one, to work together in every way. And so God then pronounced the first ceremony of covenant of marriage. When he looked at the man and said, "The man shall leave father and mother." You guys are really happy about that, I'm sure. He's got to take care of himself. Not that he hasn't been. "The man shall leave father and mother and be joined to his bride," which is uniquely put to be glued to in such a way that they're stuck together and can never be parted. And the two will become one flesh. Because the man is to initiate and the bride respond. You ladies can do everything on your own. You don't need a man. You already know that. But when you do have a man and you want to be married, you want him to initiate so you can respond. Because if he doesn't initiate love and initiate spiritual leadership, then the wife has nothing to respond to. And that's how God created us, how God made us. The unique thing that happened, though, was man decided he knew better than anyone else and better than God. Took matters into his own hands and went his own way, sinned against God. The Word of God says that all of us have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Every one of us have turned from God. And yet, God sought us. And just as Adam gave his life away, God's Son gave his life away to have a bride. When Jesus died on the cross, he became my sin, your sin. And then God poured out all the wrath and punishment that he had and hatred for sin on his own Son. And Jesus took that in our place. And in so doing, God then accepted that, forgiving us and being just and justifying us, made us to be as though we'd never sinned before. That is awesome. That is so awesome. And all we have to do is say, "I believe. I believe that Jesus is the Son of God. I believe he died for me. I believe he rose from the dead. And I want to know him personally." And if there's anyone here today that doesn't know Jesus personally, no matter what age you are, no matter what your background may be, today is the day you can begin by saying, I want to know him. If you'd say from your heart, I'm not going to ask you to say it out loud, I'm not going to give an altar call, but in this moment, if you would just say, "Lord, I want to know you. I want to know you personally," then Jesus will begin a good work in your life. And you begin to know the real and true and living God. You have salvation. Now, so Jade's giving me the look that most brides give me about this time. Which is, come on, let's get on with this thing. I came here to get married, not to get preached. We're going to do that. So Anthony, as you initiate Sejahdah's response, are you willing to take this beautiful woman to be your bride? It's not finished yet. Yeah, we're getting there. Because you're not just taking some girl, you're taking a full-blown woman, another person, your equal. And she wants you not to lead her as though she needs you to lead her, but to be a person who oversees and encourages her and creates a home for her where she feels safe, secure, loved, appreciated, and where she can blossom and become everything God's called her to be. She wants to come along your side. Are you willing to take her as your bride? Praise the Lord. We're halfway there. Jada, are you willing to take this man as your husband? And in this day and age, in this world, that means that you're going to come under his care and protection. Not that you're less than, and submission doesn't mean that you do all that he says or wants. It means that you allow him to initiate, and you're going to respond. You allow God to discipline him as you come alongside him and encourage him and help him be the mirrored image and the partner that he needs to be all that God has called him to be. Will you take him as your husband? Praise the Lord. The wedding's on. As you're already holding hands, I'd like for you to repeat after me, please. because in this moment, you're married. You've already said yes to one another. So this is done, except for now you're going to express through these vows how you intend to carry out that covenant that you've come under. Because you've just said to God, I take this woman as my bride. I take this man as my husband. We're going to live together for the rest of our lives. That's basically what you've just done. Now, how are you going to accomplish that? So, I'll start with you, Anthony, before you share your own vows. These are the traditional ones you asked me to lead you through as well. So, Anthony, repeat after me. I, Anthony, take you, Sejahdah, to be my lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, sickness and in health, till death do us part, and all this according to, God's holy word, in Jesus' name, Amen. Sejahdah, if you read that, please. I, Sejahdah, thank you, Anthony, to be my lovely wedded husband, to have and to hold, this day forward, for richer, for poorer, sickness and health, let God do his work, and all this according to God's holy word, in Jesus' name, amen. Anthony and Sejahdah have also written their vows, and so at this time, Anthony, if you begin, share your vows with.
You have been my friend since childhood. You have loved me through thick and thin and have shown me what true unconditional love is. You have encouraged me, taught me, strengthened me, and led me to be a greater man. My compass has no north
without you in my life. Sejahdah, I promise to love you and protect you as long as God in heaven permits. Your family will become my family, and I promise to love them as my own flesh and blood. I vow to be your strength and cover your weaknesses just as you do for me. I vow to be by your side through whatever trials and tribulations you may experience. I vow to always do my best in keeping your heart, mind, and body healthy. I vow to enrich your life, bring you joy, and make you laugh even when it's not appropriate. I vow to always remember and cherish what makes you unique and special to me. And I vow to always thank God for bringing you into my life. I love you, and I forever commit myself to you.
I've taken in my life. Over the years, I have cherished you as my confidant, best friend, partner, and now my husband. Today I say I do, and I vow to always be there for you and support you in everything that you do. I vow to encourage you when life, encourage you through life, when life is easy and when life is hard. I promise to always be compassionate and trustworthy, always be there to show you unconditional love. I vow to choosing you every day. I vow to always laugh with you, cry with you, eat with you, all the time. Pray with you and celebrate with you forever. I love you.
May I have the rings, please? Express their vows, expressing how they're going to live out this covenant that they've made towards one another and before God. These rings are a reminder to them of the covenant that they've entered and the vows that they've spoken. It's a reminder in the sense that it's a circle which cannot be broken except for some outside force. It's a metal that is least tarnishing, most enduring. And so as they wear these rings, it should always be a reminder that they belong to one another, and that they've made a covenant before Almighty God. And the unique thing about that is that He will see you through. Life is tough at times. You never know what's coming. Marriage can be difficult. But our God is so gracious and kind and loving. He will see you through every difficulty. Let these rings remind you of that as well. So Anthony, if you would place on your bride's finger her ring. And repeat after me, please. With this ring, I wed you.
I wed you.
And give unto you.
And give unto you.
My love.
My love.
My devotion.
My devotion.
And my life.
And my life.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Mr. Jada, you'd also place that on the finger of your groom's hand. And repeat after me. Mm-hmm. With this ring.
With this ring.
I wed you.
I wed you.
And give unto you.
And give unto you.
My love.
My love.
My devotion.
My devotion.
And my life.
And my life.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Good. Thank you. Well, you've done it. You're married. That's awesome.
Thank you, Pastor Steve.
But let me encourage you, please. As we've been meeting and as we've been talking about marriage and your life together and just some of the unique ways that you live life and your personalities and how that's meshing together, my main encouragement to you is look up and trust God. Now that sounds kind of, that's what I should say as a pastor, perhaps, but it's more than that. It's acknowledging His presence day by day. Acknowledging Him even when you don't like each other and you're furious with one another. I know that'll never happen. Just ask those of us who are married. But in that moment, that's when you call upon Him. And I encourage you, Anthony, take the lead in this.
Yes, sir.
Call upon Him. Open the Word of God and read it to your bride. Read it together. Go after the Lord with everything you have. And you'll see He will bless your life. He will bless your marriage. He will bless your family in a wonderful, powerful way. He has great things in store for the two of you. But you've got to seek Him with all your heart. Okay?
Yes, sir.
All right. So, with all that said, if you put your hands together, with great honor and great privilege, according to the covenant that God has made relating to marriage, I pronounce you husband and wife in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And what God has put together, let no man put asunder. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Will you join me in prayer? And if you agree, if you just put your hand out and as if you were laying a hand upon them. Father God, we thank you for this young couple. We thank you for the years of life they've spent together as friends, partners, and now they've come together as husband and wife. We ask, Lord, that you would give them a brilliant future, that you would give them grace, understanding, insight, direction, empowering, that everything that you've created them to be would come forth in great beauty for your glory and honor. And that you'd use this marriage to exemplify the relationship of Jesus and His church. And we thank you for that, Lord. Bless them, bless them, bless them. And we agree together in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Now, that your husband and wife, your moms, they came up, and as they gave you life, that represented them lighting this candle. So I'd like for you to go and take the outside candles, each representing your life. And then go ahead and light the center candle.
There we go.
And then blow out those two candles. Indicating that you're no longer single, that you've come together and have become one, husband and wife. Amen?
Amen.
Good. You'd come back to this area. Now, Anthony, there's a tradition at the close of a ceremony, which is kissing your bride. It's not necessary. If you prefer not to, I'd understand. But if you'd like to kiss your bride, this would be the moment, the appropriate moment to do so.
Thank
so you
sir.
May kiss your bride if you'd like.
Hey!
And if you take your bouquet from your maid of honor, and then turn and face your guests. May I introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Brimmer.
I think we wait till the music starts coming. Oh, okay. Yeah.
Yeah.